This production centers upon CNC Swiss Machining. With Swiss Machining, the tools are approximately a quarter inch from the guide bushing. The advantages are a very stable holding system, minimized vibration, minimized surface chatter, and holding tighter tolerances. This is a Citizen CNC Swiss machine. The bar feeder holds several 12-foot long bars of precision ground stock. The bars are stacked side by side at a slight incline. As one bar has been completely machined, gravity advances the next bar into the guide channel. Once the new bar is in the guide channel, it is pushed into the machine from the back of the bar feeder by the finger collet. The finger collet works in unison with the main collet to deliver the bar through the guide bushing, where it is positioned for machining by the appropriate stationary gang and tooling and live tooling. So this process can be viewed by the camera. We will be machining brass. This allows us to eliminate the cutting oil. As we said earlier, each bar starts out 12 feet in length and gets shorter as each part is produced. We're viewing the main collet of the Swiss machine. We're beginning this process by machining a spherical shape on the tip of a 1/8 inch diameter bar. The tool then reduces the original diameter of the bar behind the sphere. A tapered profile is then turned onto the part. The sub-collet, which is a second independent collet, will now accept the tip end of the part from the main collet. The bar is then fed into the sub-collet to maintain maximum stability. And then two flats are milled at 180 degrees from each other. The flats are then deburred by the end mill. This is repeated two more times on this part. The part is then cut off and fed through the sub-collet, and the machine begins a new part.